With the wrap.
That was good, you got it.
Well, I love that, to a certain point, I love when Kafka was the rage.
No, I'm not.
To a certain extent. But I looked him up with his daughter and everybody.
Peanut butter.
He was a little short of the goal.
No, chicken pesto. Yeah, that was a snack, this is more like me.
Oh, yeah, of course, that's, so wait, he doesn't say that.
Oh, there's one, the woman that showed up.
What happened?
The woman from the, battery park.
Came here?
Yes, she said it's her second time.
Oh, really?
From,
what's her name?
All white.
That's like half of the name.
Sure.
It is that she was kind of talking about.
Oh, yeah, maybe it's that. I don't know if that was Barbara? You could point out to me.
That's a daughter of that.
Oh, really?
You know, that, like, well, I mean, I don't know, too, but, like, that's for the location.
It's great. Oh, it's really? Oh, that's right. Nice, special days, yes.
Yeah.
And the weather is no shadows or anything, you know, so it's everything that's not a good day to go, you know.
But it's great for photography.
Oh, it's great for photography, but I'm not taking pictures.
He obviously was bright, the old man. You know, it was, it's funny. Anyway, he's a sweetheart. Tom's a sweetheart. And I should have told him this thing.
Who's Tom?
It was his father's
house. No worries.
And actually, it was cool with him.
Looking at it
right now. Okay, good. How, when's your first one?
It's not
until,
we put them way off.
I think one, the woman who does great watercolor.
Yes.
With glasses, tall, short, gray hair.
Is she really old? Because you know how some of them are really
Old? Yeah, well, she's active. No.
But she's not long. Well, because some, is she a good watercolor?
I think so.
Because one's really good, she's kind of old.
Well, no, not her. Okay. I don't think so.
I don't know how many people's names are there.
Me neither.
Yeah, I get.
I mean, she recognized you right away. And he's like, did I interview her? No.
I don't know.
It was good that we spent that day together. It was good. Yeah. With a beer.
You're going to sit here? Or are you sitting there?
Wherever you, you want the spot?
No. I think, so, I mean, just to get out.
And what did he, what was he, a pilot?
Oh, no. He was a desert rat because he's small plane.
Oh, because he went in the tunnel?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Those guys are like,
yeah. He had a tough. So, they didn't know that until 40 years later when he said I mean, it's coming out with more of a salt. Yeah, but I mean, you know.
Mandible.
Yeah,
and maxilla and mandible.
Okay.
Do you want any of the disarticulated bones?
No.
Well,
now we have a generation that don't do anything.
The bones. West. She's always gone from the poor world to the counting.
Oh, really? I don't see anything. Well, I'm trying to
get through this. Okay, everybody, calm down.
No, no, but to see that happening after having experienced it, and it's so hard. It's so hard to see another generation.
Somebody, are you almost ready, Susan?
Uh-huh, it's on.
Okay.
Okay.
What's the date today? September 6th. Okay, can you see me? I just want to...
Yeah.
I want to introduce the last lecture in a series of lectures that have been given by Sayed Moumtaz from Morocco for Spring Studio on Wednesday afternoon, and we've all had a wonderful time so far. So let's welcome.
Thank you all for your assistance. So today we will study a part of body is really special. It's gonna show up how body is missing and how face is different about other side of other part of body. For example, we will see that for arm, when we study all muscles and bones, we can see and draw better the arm. Okay, because we know, and it's different about face, because even we study all muscles that we do, it's not enough to understand, because there is two parts of the face, a visible part and an invisible part. And that's why phenomenology, it's very important. And I invite you to read an amazing book of Emmanuel Levinas. And his book in French is Totalité. Totalité. You can find the translation. Et infini. He spoke about epiphany of the face. Epiphany in France. Epiphany. Or transcendance. Transcendence. So it's a philosopher, it's not artist, but he helped us to see how it's a deep subject about face. So we will start first of all to understand the skull and some muscles, and after we can so the visible skin side, and after we can talk, and I can try to explain the invisible dimension. So to summarize, skull is divided in two parts: la boîte crânienne. It's la boîte crânienne. Box of skulls, I don't know the translation, and the face. And only bones whose articulate, whose can move, it's mâchoire inférieure, the only one. All other one is not moving. Okay, so to and our habitude when we draw, so and the profile. We can simplify la boîte crânienne, la mastoïde is the bone that we touch behind the ear, this one. It's very important because it gives us sternocleidomastoidian. So, and sometimes it's a landmark to start our meridian, mâchoire inférieure. And when we understand skull, the form, I can see, for example, I have my face. It's amazing. You see? And with the puff, I can see the invisible. So, why? Because here I have an orbit, os, and I have my skull, profile. Of course, there's many different morphology of skulls. So this
you
one.
Make that look so easy.
Thank you. You know, the most difficult thing to have is to be simple. Yeah, it's very complex. So now, and our imaginary world and attitude, when we draw, Lockbit, I don't know the name, Lockbit, often we do this or this. So we can, if we see really deeply with the passions, we can see there is a movement, like in bone. So I can make a small movement like that. I'm not exaggerating. You see, there is a movement. It's not circle. So I can. I have this movement, beautiful, pop, and other movements. Okay, so here I can have force metal. And I simplify, and I have. And now, when we see that when we realize a portrait, the more important side is skull, not the muscles. We have to feel skulls, really love the shape, the form, the more deep, the smoothness, the hardness of the And I will not stay any longer about muscles, but I give you the more important. Of course, we have this one we can massage and here.
Temple.
It's work.
We
yeah.
Temple.
Yes.
Forehands.
No, temple is here.
Forehands.
It's really when
forehead.
You make muscle
you
with
mean
your
forehead?
Lover or friend. Yeah, it's really yeah. So we have frontalis. That is number one. Okay. Another. If we contomash.
Masseter.
Yes.
Two.
So here masseter is really a powerful. You know the man, the strong man who will tear the cars with with their mouth. It's because they have masseter. It's really strong. They measure it, the force. It's just amazing. So masseter is a beautiful tool as a muscle. Masseter is here. Okay. And when also when I'm mashed, you can see. No, no, here.
The temporalis?
He try it. With mushroom.
Yeah.
He works too. Uh-huh. It's very powerful. Muscles and the beautiful too. Here, all these parts. Pop. The digitation. Fingering. Okay. And to move to les interosseux, pas les we have this one. So to explain, to give this one, I have first of all to draw my mouth, and around the mouth I have these muscles. I would design, I would draw in all this. And this one, he take this to move the mouth. Okay?
Number four here.
It's very important for the eyes. Another muscle here, very important to move this one. So I have this one, and I have this one. And this one, it's the second, this one, number six. So number five, it came here, and I have number six. Okay. And I have another muscle, very important, zygomatic. You really move the face and all the movement, zygomatic. I have the first one who communicates with this muscle of eye. And another here. And they are very important to move all this place. Finish. I have two muscles here. So it's number nine. This one is fine. And above this muscle, I have number 10. With charcoal, I can master it. And I have another sweet and cute muscle here. It's mortalis. Mortalis. So when you cry, it's very cute, very romantic muscle. It's very romantic, very sensitive muscle here. Well, so Samurai, and with your chalk, because it's beautiful.
I have a red chalk.
I can do.
I don't think you wrote orbicularis or
yes.
Up there.
I forgot it.
And then oris for the mouth. But it's not
yes,
no
I forgot it, I forget it.
So that'll be number X. Okay? Oris.
Can the number be written other than pink? Because I can't see them from here. So when you photograph them, you won't be able to see the number.
I'll show them.
No, the corresponding. No. It's not gonna make any sense.
I have them right here. I have them on my
everybody.
You have to memorize this anyway.
No, it's not that I want to memorize.
So start memorizing now.
That.
Everyone should know all of these muscles.
In French.
They just mean, in Latin, they mean of the front of the head, from the temporal region. Masseter must have something to do with chewing. Orbicularis oculi just means the muscle that goes around the eye. The oculi, you know that? And then levator is the lifter upper, labii is lips,
there's another, superiors above. There's another muscle here, who master la bouche.
The 12.
It's the horizontal like this.
Okay. In the flesh.
So, now we can know by heart these muscles, but for me it's not enough to understand the mystery of
Can
yeah.
you use black chalk to make the number over there?
Yes.
Oh, the black. Oh, you want the numbers in black? I can't see them either. I just hear. I listen to them, and then I look at the number over there. I didn't realize. I was drawing down here. I didn't realize.
He understands my English.
You know. I know, but I didn't realize, I didn't even see him writing them, so I just draw
it. I know you had him there.
Yeah.
Of course you did. You know, it's interesting. The minute you start putting the muscles, you get an expression in the face.
As soon as you name one, you start
using an expression. So that's what's interesting. People who have hot hops and
they get a bit of all that.
All the muscles
stuff.
Are frozen.
This one,
Buccinator is number 12.
I obviously don't have any. Yeah.
Buccinator. Yes.
I don't and then Mentalis is 11.
I should.
Depressor, you haven't done Anguli Oris. You haven't done Depressor of the Angle of the Mouth. Everyone gets finally.
Yeah.
Did you?
Number. So now it's just to summarize.
He did 10.
Okay.
Oh, I see it. Okay.
So we can study and even make a decision to know all the names of these muscles, because we were not enough to understand in my vision idea.
Scary.
Yes. So if. So that's why we take some minutes to reflect about face, about the miracle of face. The attitude don't help us to see how it's amazing to have a face. And every day, since morning till the evening, we meet thousands faces. But we are not sensitive about the miracle of these faces. And that's why art is very important. Art reveals what is extraordinary in simple matter, in simple stuff, in simple movements, simple things. And there is, so if we reflect, if we see about faces, when we want to insult someone, we don't insult foot or finger or it's not a face and all languages. Why? Because we hurt the person. We touch the place where the secret feeling of my identity is in my face. Even if we touch someone and his shoulder is not hurt him, but if you touch him in his face, touch my face, because it's. And also, if I have a scar, if an accident, I have a scar in my hand or my feet, it's no matter. But if I have a scar in my face, it's all my feeling, my existence. It's changes. It's awful. It's catastrophic. So. And when we think about that we are more than 8 billion in life, 8 billion through space and time, and each one of us has his face, we are unique. So making, realizing a portrait, it's not copy some detail, eye and nose, but searching what makes you unique. It's impossible. That's why I love the work of Giacometti, Alberto Giacometti. Also, Francis Bacon. And I don't know if Antonin Artaud is not a painter, he's a writer about theater, but he did autoportrait from mirror. Antonin, please try to see Antonin Artaud. He was sick mentally, and he realized some beautiful, and strong, powerful autoportrait. It's a very, very, very. I love the. And there's many others, but for me, it's really. So Giacometti, he's really desperate because he can never find resemblance, real resemblance. And I can understand him because what's resemblance, for example, for you? If I want to search your resemblance, if resemblance of now, on the morning,
and where with your wife, your mother, or when you are sad, when you're tired, there is many you. And it's impossible to find the, that's why portrait is different, that's the other part of, and also, for example, when I come here in the eye, so normally, common artists, when they draw the eye, with lighting, etc. And they love what more his brightness, its lighting, more is like a photography. But it's hard. It's like a plastic. It's not living, not breathing. Do you understand? So, but here, if I draw here, I try to draw. I have my soul, okay? Light. I don't draw anything visible, only invisible, abstract. And it's breathe. There is nothing visible, only invisible. And if you stay back, I can feel it thinking, feeling, suffering, or feeling happy. So there is two sides of portrait. Of course, we have to master the technical, etc. But there is something we can master. That's why artist is artist. You have to feel, adventure. Ontological adventure and people. And that's why sometimes it's dangerous. So there is eye and there is the gaze. We can fall in love just with the gaze. We can kill someone, a child, with the gaze. And if you are in a coffee shop and you stare at someone that you don't know him or her, you disturb this person. And she or he can come and look at it. You know, you disturb it. Why? It's only a gaze. So now, this gaze, which muscles move the gaze? There is no muscles. And there is invisible sight. That's why we have to understand what is face, what is human being, what is am I a body or I have a body? And with eyes, I can tell many things without speaking. It's amazing. So how can I do to draw this gate? It's very impossible. It's only artist can live this atmosphere. So that's why the face is a good example. I can muscle all muscles. I can know all score, okay? But to do a portrait, there's another dimension that we had to be sensitive. And that's why philosophy, phenomenology, for me, it's necessary. Because it's a way to think, to ask what I'm doing. There's people dying there, and me, I'm drawing. I think with philosophy and with real work, I can give a real good reason. Because life without art, it's a death. It's nonsense. Art, it gives sense to my life, my behavior, my contact with other, and we just to see the other country. When you see when there's the violence, the frustration, because there's no art, less art, and the country where we can find the richness of art and culture, we see the citizens smiling and living really normally. So for me, portrait, it's not only copy some detail of a face, eye, nose. This is technical. We have to know it, but we have to transgress this
aside and go to ask the real question. What is the face? What is the gaze? What is the eye? What is the life? So my drawing, I draw not to show the others, I'm not drawing now, it's a childish. I draw to face my demon, to my question, what I'm doing, why I'm here in this life, what is sense of my life. And also what I love in poetry, we can't lie. And people who lie, you can know it because they take photographs. Okay? They can photograph and they copy photograph. And sometimes even in photograph they make some sculpture. Why? Why we do this? Because we can't see. Okay? Because we try to give an image that I can see. Art for me, it's truth, it's honesty. We have to be genuine what I'm doing. I don't lie to myself. If I can see, drawing tell me what I can see. So I have turned to say that in photography, you know, this is another subject in poetry, very, very important. It's a death. Photography, it's a death. I take for a photo, it's a death. Mm-hmm. I take image, it's a death.
It's death, it's what?
Death, la mort.
La mort.
I die.
Why?
Well, it's a philosophical question. Because it's past already.
Or because of what you said before, that only
it's doing something it's right here. It's not moved.
Finding. Perfect. Done. Finished.
Done? Yeah, it's a, I take photo, it's a past. I take photo, it's the past. Because time. But when I am doing a lot from model, what I feel something because there's no death, it's life. I live here now, and I feel, and I don't think another things. I see only your face, and I draw you. And the beauty of this exercise that I'm looking for. How you are you uniqueness, okay? And this is the beauty. Each one of us is beautiful because he is unique. It's not the beauty of a magazine alone. No, the beauty is it's true. It's the ability, and it's not easy. Also,
can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
The body language and the facial language. Do you put the two together? Would you say portraits are unique in their own self and figure doing? I'm not making any sense. When you do the whole figure, I mean, when you do a painting, the whole person, body language, and the facial language, it's one person. Now, the body language, is it separate from the portrait? Would you say portraits are unique in their own self as a form of art? Versus the composition of the whole.
Normally this discussion is about human being, okay? Human being. But the capital for me, the center of human being is the face, and the capital of the face is the gaze. For me. Because when I talk to someone, I don't talk to you and see in your finger that even the babies, they see the eyes, there is something in the eyes, in the soul. So it's more, you see the portrait of Jean Genet by Giacometti, and he's in the Beaubourg in Paris. And if you see, you can see it on the internet or the book. This is a portrait of Jean Genet. This is a head, small head. Okay. So here, the line, they're smooth and soft, okay? But more I approach the face, it becomes violent. It's smooth. It's wonderful. It's amazing. It's really, Giacometti, he understood, he felt how
yeah,
it's
that,
strong.
That answers the question that I asked.
Oh,
thank you. That's very good.
Yeah. So, my hand,
it's not, I told before, it's not controlling only a body, but it's controlling my thought. I talk with my hand. Yes. So all body, it's come from my mind, and we can't separate part of body, I think, really. So I love doing poetry because we can't lie. There is some people who want to do art just to have image of artist. And there's some people who make art because if they don't make art, their life is nonsense. Okay? Their life has a sense when they practice because it's urgent. I have to draw to see and to establish contact with reality and with my inner person, inner world. Okay? So, if I can't draw, that is me, I can't see. Drawing is not copying, it's a way to see. And I can draw a tree, of course. I can draw a flower. But for a tree, if I exaggerate a branch,
branch.
Thank you. So if I exaggerate a branch, if you show it to a friend, it's a tree. But if you exaggerate an arm or knee of human, if you show it, oh, it's exaggerated, because human body has his law. We have to respect it. We have to master my sight and my expression. So we can't lie. If something wrong, the drawing show to you, there is a mistake. And a real artist, the passionate, will love to make mistakes. Mistakes, it's beautiful, because it's honesty. And it's if I make attention, I can progress because of mistakes. So when I work with my students, I told them, more there is mistakes, more I'm happy. Because it means you are struggling with your own sight. It's amazing. It's a beauty, and you know it. You feel it. When you really, you draw honestly, I feel something beautiful on me. I'm working, I'm not lying. I don't pretend being another person. I'm me. If you love me with my default, with my quality. And that's why I love art. So I hope that time to time, when we walk, when we have coffee, we can see persons without judging them, just to see the miracle. Because it's amazing. I call that a love. So thank you so much.
She's picked up.